When I was filming at the zoo in London and in Whipsnade, we made friends with some of the keepers who helped us to get our cameras in a favourable position. And one of them was the keeper of apes and monkeys, head keeper, and his star was Guy, the gorilla, at the London Zoo. I went to take some photographs and he kindly let me go across the barrier to put my lens through the bars. He had to be near with an iron bar just in case he goes for me, because he could reach out 2 or 3 feet between those iron bars. But he was very peaceful. He just sat there and I took my pictures, and when I ran out of film I said, oh, I must change my film in my Hasselblad. And he said, okay, I'll go and get some more grapes, because he was throwing grapes to him to keep him in the background there. And this iron bar he had a hook on the end, and he hooked it on the fence. And while I was reloading my camera, Guy came slowly and lifted that up gently, that iron bar, and took it into the cage. Now, he could have done a lot of damage with it. There was a glass plate behind him, and he just put it gently down in front of him. When the keeper came back, he noticed that and said to him, give me that back. No answer. No gesture. Give me that back, he said. And Guy goes and picks up a little bit of paper which was next to the bar and brought it to the keeper. And went back again. Give me that back. Again, nothing, but the fourth time he did pick it up and gave it to the keeper without any trouble. He was a great character.
But then it was printed in Sunday Times, a half page, and it was a huge correspondence.
It still is quite a favourable picture. Virginia McKenna used it in a book against zoos. She and her son had a movement against zoos, and it was used in many papers and books. It's just the shadow of the bars on his face. At Whipsnade, we went into the fields with animals, and the only time we almost got into trouble was with kangaroos. They started chasing us, and we just made it to the fence and across. The head keeper and I. It was a lovely man, the head keeper, Mr. Bates. Unfortunately, no longer with us. So I've been a zookeeper since 1937, really. And in the early days, we got on very well with keepers, and they were obliging. They got a few shillings from us, which they badly needed. Their wages were rather bad, which has improved, of course, a lot.